Nicole and I, we started to do fun, but we know the inner city ministry. And I met a young man, and he lived here in Atlanta, and I came back here. When I came back here, you know, we've been saying we need to play ball for almost over a whole year. Said, man, we gotta play ball, and he actually played semi-pro ball, so I'm a lover of basketball. I mean, I've been hooping, maybe short, but I can hoop. Played a year college ball.
Played against Jason Williams and them NBA players. I could hoop.
Take it serious. So don't take my short statures. I can't hoop. I could hoop. So I went to go play against him, and we were playing, and we actually got to play ball just one on one at the gym, and we were talking, and after we played, and you know, I'm 40 now, so you know, I can't do what I used to do, and so I was winning. But then he turned it up. He ended up winning that night. And you know, we said, man, we're gonna play again. You know, we're gonna play again. You know, he won 4, I won 3. I did okay. And then after that, it was later that one Saturday night, I was leaving. It was not too long after that, I was driving up on 75. And there was a lot of traffic. And I was just like, man, this is another Saturday night. So the next day I saw on Facebook that he had died in a car crash. And the thing about it was, I started to think, man, did I actually talk to him about Jesus? Like, you know, I always felt I had time. You know, I was sitting there, was kicking it, I was talking about life issues. And you always think you have time, but you don't know how much time you have. And I'm taking that as a burden. I'm like, man, we should know that Christ should be everything. I want to read a passage for you. It's from 1 Corinthians 2. And if tonight, he said tonight is about what? Calvary. Right? Calvary is entitled the reference point of our lives. And I believe that Christ should be that. I don't mean it passively, actively. That Christ should be our everything. And I want to read this passage. It says this. You should know. 1 Corinthians 2, it says this in verse 1. When I came to you, brothers, I did not come with eloquence or superior wisdom, as I proclaimed to you the testimonies about God. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear, with much trembling. My message and my preaching were not wise and persuasive words, but the demonstration of the Spirit's power, so that your faith may not rest upon man's wisdom, but upon the power of God. I care to know nothing but Jesus Christ and Him crucified. So I want to do something a little different today. I actually got all stand with me. Just stand with me, please. Stand with me. I want it to be silent. Please stop playing. Just silence. As we worship today, I shouldn't have to manufacture your worship or try to persuade you to worship or use eloquence to convince you to worship. I shouldn't even have to be creative in my ability or even have to believe that if I say it the right way or even use the right note, that somehow then you will then believe that Christ is your one and all. It's actually the reference point of Christ and Him crucified alone. And if you truly, sincerely see Him on that cross, that it should bring you to tears. That He died to save you. So I'm going to pray to begin. But I ask that you will pray and ask God to come into your heart. So that as we have worship today, it's not just lip service. It's not just another display of worship, but one in which we truly desire God. We truly desire Christ. So that others also may receive this very gift that we have received. So as we close our eyes, please, everyone, close your eyes, bow your heads. Lord, we realize that we should be grateful even in our silence. When no one's around, even when the music is off, when we're not in church, when we're not hearing a sermon, when we're all alone, we should realize that you are sufficient. And that we should recollect and we should glimpse, we should meditate upon what you have done, dying on that cross, the ultimate sacrifice to give us life. So that our belief may not be on how well a preacher preached the sermon, or how well somebody sang a song. That's what the scripture said. That it did not rely upon persuasive words or cunning measures, but upon you, Christ crucified. Lord, we ask that your spirit may be here. And that we may feel your presence, and that we may know you. And we leave changed. For this we ask on the only name that has given life, on the precious name of Jesus. Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior. In his name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
for me. Think back when you didn't think you was gonna make it, but you still made it. Think back when you didn't know what was gonna happen, yet you made it. So tonight, you need to go back and think of all those times. And tonight, I said this morning, tonight, like Pastor Jimmy said, your closet worship needs to match your outward worship. When I'm in need, I can pay my worship at home. When my kids are not here, when my wife are not here, it's different. That's the worship that's coming out tonight. Everything for me, man. Come on, y'all, let's stay together.
You are my soul. Praise the Lord, anybody. Praise the Lord, somebody. It was about 11 o'clock. I put a stink in the oven to reheat. I put it on about 400. It was about 11 o'clock. I woke up about 4 o'clock that morning. Smoke everywhere. So listen, tonight, I didn't come to give it no heart to worship. I come to bless the Lord, amen. I come to bless the Lord, amen. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. Because he's worthy of the glory, amen. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the saints, his name is worthy to be praised.
Oh, can touch three people and say, he's a miracle worker. I say, he's a miracle worker.
Yeah. let me present the singers on stage before I work them out, before they pass out by the end of the service. I'll let you guys introduce ourselves.
My name is Alicia.
Soprano.
Willow.
Alright, some of us, you guys can sit down for a minute. Some of us singers have been with me for over 10 years. Seth's been with me for over 8 years. I've tried a lot of things. This past week, a friend of mine asked me, "You're still doing this SOP thing, so, you know, if they have to ask you how to define the ministry in one word." And I started thinking, I've been doing this for 10 years, and I've tried a whole lot. I've tried different avenues. I said, when they type in the Spirit of Praise Ministry.org, I want them to be empowered. I want them to be encouraged. And I want them to know we're from a Haitian background. So I would never forget where I came from. In the 10 years, I've tried different ventures. If you guys remember, there was SOP Fitness. That was a big fail. Well, except for me, I kept the fitness part going. We started up, except when I'm competing with PJ, he beats me every week. All right, PJ, shout out. We tried a prayer line as well, and that didn't go according to plan. But one thing about myself and the ministry is I want to be just in more of music, more of singing. I know a lot of singers, there's a lot of great group out there, but I want to have substance. Starting January 2020, if you guys see what's on the board, we're gonna branch into podcasting. So, first Monday of January, I think it's January 6th, we will have our first podcast series. They've been recorded already. It won't be me preaching, it won't be me talking. My accent would not be on there. But I have, yes, PJ, praise God. To God be with us. But I recruited dynamic preachers to make sure that I encourage somebody. I want to make sure that where my voice can't get, where the ministry can't get, where I can't go, but the word of God reaches somebody. And I wanted to keep it very basic. At the end of the day, back to the Calvary is that's the essence of it all. So this is the new project that the ministry will embark in, starting. It's called Spirit of Praise Ministry Monday Matters. It's going to be every Monday, starting January 6th. We already have a whole series recorded already, and I'm excited to what God is doing. The single has been doing great. And again, going back to not feeding into the hype, is trying to give you a message that is relevant to today's time. Those are the way you guys can follow us on social media to stay in contact, to stay aware with the ministry and to know what's going on. We are recording, so we do have I'm in the studio recording a project. I have some of my singers here, and there's a lot coming for 2020. And I told somebody, if I'm still alive, I'm gonna give it all in 2020. I'm not downplaying it, not anymore. So tonight, I'll ask for your support. I think it's not over here for the Cash App. But I would not try to pass a collection plate. If you guys know, what's the cash on it? You want a collection plate instead? All right, collection plate. Somebody asked for a collection plate. But some people have a Cash App as well. So while they're going to collect anything you have for help, and I also have a trying to go to let you guys know the Cash App for the issue. And then the band will take us through some to a song, and we'll go right back into worship. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. God, we pray that everything that was collected today that is being used for your glory, is being used to push your word, to push kingdom ministry, kingdom work even further. We ask that if you make the sacrifice to give to me, that you turn on your blessing 100-fold.
We ask you to be with everybody who's in this room. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Bible said that I am, that he is the great I am. That he has given us everything that we need. That the great I am provides for me. That no matter what the situation is, no matter what we do in life, the great I am provides for me. I have everything I need. The great I am provides for me.
Jehovah. Thank you.
better.
Look at Jesus, she's been magnified in this place. let it fall. Oh, more right now is the best. Something in his spirit, man. Like he owns me. He testifies of the Lord of God. The love of God, you can feel it through him. It's real. Can I hear you one more time? Come on, man. Let's go on a little solo thing. Yeah, that. Guitar thing you do. There we go, there we go. I love how he does that. Come on, you're right, just like.
You get there, you sit down, and it seems as if you get your every question that you realize that I can praise God in here.
Yes.
And then I get out there and I'm silent. It is easy to praise God when everyone around you believes what you believe. But what would you say when the enemy attacks you? When you're all alone and everyone around you does not believe? Would you still cry out the same way? Present your body as a living sacrifice. Receive the ridicule. Receive the hatred. Receive all that they offered, but still love them as Jesus said, love them. Then he says, you have learned what is true and proper worship. We worship God with our lives, not just with our voice. So I'm going to tell you that you make sure you hum that tune. But when somebody asks you, who is God to you? Don't shudder, don't hide. You speak up. He has been everything to me. I've seen his mercy. I've seen his grace. And he is more than enough. Let me tell you about my Jesus. Will that be your response? That is worship. That is worship. So we're going to pray. But my desire is that we live out this worship. Live it out. Not only as if our life depends on it, but as if those who do not know that their lives depend. Worship can change people's lives. So let us bow our heads. Lord, we realize that you have been more than good to us. When we have ran away from you, you still chase after us. You would not leave us to our own demise. That is how much you love us. You love us with an unfailing love. Lord, you loved us to repentance. For that, we are grateful that you have been so good. And so we have lifted our voice. We have worshipped you today. This house, because of your goodness, in view of your mercy, in view of all that you have done, your grace, but Lord, we also ask that we might live this forever. This is not just a moment in time. This will be our lives, a life of praise and worship. Thank you.
Very humble. You want to admit, right? May have to give this.
I tell you guys, I have not rehearsed with this band not once. So I sent them the song. They told me, we got this. And we have yet. They did not let me down. Not once. And then deliver it. Thank you for coming. We appreciate you. Follow us on social media and you stay tuned for our next project. Be blessed.